H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Hi guys, welcome to H2K Infosys. Myself Ankit Reddy, I'm having more than 6 years of experience in IT industry as well as in teaching field. Here I'll be taking the classes for .NET. .NET will be covering C#.NET, ASP.NET and SQL Server database. So in order to complete an application, it is required to have database as well. So here, as part of this course, we'll be covering C#.NET, ASP.NET, SQL Server. There are other databases also there, but we'll be taking SQL Server database for our course. Here, we can develop with .NET many kind of applications. One is a console application, and then one is a Windows application we call it as. Then other one is a web applications. Fourth one is mobile applications. So these many kinds of applications we can develop by using Visual Studio. And if somebody asks you that which language are you learning, please do not go and say that I'm learning .NET. So .NET is a framework. Please remember that .NET is a framework, not a language. It's a framework under which there are many languages that are supported by Microsoft Visual Studio. Examples are C#.NET, VB.NET, JSharp.NET, like many other languages are there, under which the languages which are got famous is C#.NET. And the next famous is VB.NET. So according to your choice, you can choose the one which you wanted to learn. And in the market, more requirement is there for C#.NET. Organizer expecting that a candidate should have a experience in a C#.NET along with ASP.NET. The combinations are like C#.NET plus ASP.NET and VB.NET plus ASP.NET. So whichever you are taking, ASP.NET will be a common. Why is this ASP.NET common? Is this ASP.NET for developing web applications. So whenever you hear the word as ASP.NET, you think that it is for web applications. So whenever you wanted to create a web application, you should learn about ASP.NET. So you think about ASP.NET, that is for web application purpose. And SQL Server is required. Why it is required is, it is a database. Whenever you wanted to frequently use one application or a website, like social networking websites nowadays we are using, Facebook, Gmail, Twitter, whatever it is. So today you have registered into that social networking site and tomorrow you wanted to log into the same website. How it is possible? So at the time of registration, we'll be storing data into our database, and whenever he comes back and log into the same application, we are checking that his credentials are existing or not. If it is existing, we'll be allowing him to log into that particular website or application. So that a database is required. Here, this console application will be as same as our command prompt. Let me show you that command prompt, how it looks like. This is a CMD is a command to open a command prompt. A console application will look like this. So console application will be used to know about more about C#.NET. We'll be learning more in this console application about the logic, what we are going to implement, and the basic things, very basic things you should do. Start from here. The thing is, if you start learning directly web application, you will not understand the basic things and your base will not be strong. So whatever it is, whatever the language you are learning, the basic things are very, very important. So we'll be starting with the console application. Once you understand the console application concepts, then it is easy to understand the web application. And I'm skipping this Windows applications. Why? The other name for Windows application is a standalone application. This means the name is a self-explanatory. Stand alone. It doesn't require anything. And as how C#.NET got famous like compared to VB.NET, same way web applications are famous compared to Windows applications. Organizer expecting a candidate should be possessed experience with a web application but not a Windows application. Yes, I agree with Windows application experience guys also required, but percentage wise very less. Maybe out of 100 people required 5 to 6 resumes from Windows application. The remaining 90% resumes they need from the web application experience. Why? Why is it not got famous and why it is so much famous with the web application? What is the advantages of web application? What are the problems with Windows application? Let us see in a quick. Suppose web application versus Windows application. Here, I said that Windows application is a standalone application. A standalone means applications which we will be running, like example, let me tell you that Calci. So it's a calculator. This is a calculator which had come along with us operating system that we have got installed into our computers. So this doesn't require anything to run this application. Means that it is independent from all the things. So when you install something into your computer, then that will be a standalone application. So you don't want to have to connect to anything, like it should not be in a network, should not be required internet access. So this is called a standalone application. And remember that your client is asking you to prepare or you to come up with an application that is a standalone application. Example, I'm showing this one. Maybe this kind of application your client is asking to develop. So today you have developed this and given to him. A standalone application or a Windows application will be having .exe files. You would have seen this .exe files. Whenever you are installing something into your computers, you should double click on this .exe file. You will be running this file. So after you develop an application accordingly as per the user requirements, you will be giving .exe file. Suppose it is a Calci. Then you will be distributing to his customers. Say 1000 customers are there or 2000 customers are there for him. A client will be having customers. So he has given this .exe to his 2000 employees. After some point of time, your client feel that he wanted to add some additional features in it. Suppose in this place of calculator, he wanted to add in his company name or some other features you wanted to add. How to do that? So your client will come back to you and ask you to do the changes for the existing application. Yes, you analyze that and you feel that okay, we can add it to this existing application. You agreed for the terms and conditions. What will happen after 6 months of time or 1 month or 1 year time? You have added the new features for the existing application, then it will become a CALCI 1.0 version dot exe had given to the client. So what will happen after sending you these requirements? You will be creating this new application, then you have to hand over this new application to the client. Then client what will do is, again he will take this new exe file and he has to submit to the 2000 employees. And what those 2000 employees need to do is, they should uninstall this one and then they should install this one, just because they need to see the company name here. There's a small change. So this is a very cumbersome job. The maintenance will be very tough, and this kind of any additional features added, taking to the all the clients is very much a tough job, because it's a calculator and it won't take much space in your application, in your computer. In reality, the applications will also be taking much more space into your project, I mean in your computers. If you don't have the space, again you need to delete something else to provide required space for this application. That's also a problem. So the web applications, in the case of web applications, you no need to provide any exe files to the clients. What will happen is, after creating a web application, we will be keeping that in a server. So server will be a physical thing, it will be there somewhere else. We will be hearing these words, server is down for some point of time. So server is not reacting. Whenever you are trying to access any web applications on your own, maybe server is down for this particular time. This kind of message will be seen. So what is that? Actually, server is a web server, we call it as. After creating your web application, instead of having this exe funda, what will happen is, we'll be keeping a web application in a web server. Keeping a web application in a web server. So what will happen? Why do we keep it in a web server? When you keep your application in a web server, your clients or your customers, whoever it is, they can access your application, that's called a web application, via web browser. What is that web browser? Web browsers are Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Opera, whatever it is, the web browsers we are using. So to access the web application, user required a web browser with internet connection. That's it. So he no need to install anything, and he don't need to provide some space also, of comparatively very less space. So you require some KBs to open a web browser. That's it. How big the application is doesn't matter. You can access from the website, from your web browser. And here, the enhancements for the current application, you no need to give every time this exes. What will happen? Via internet only, they can access the new features. And if you observe, in a banking application, sometime they will be giving some messages saying that our application is under maintenance, please come back after so and so time. Otherwise they will be providing some timing before the maintenance taking place. From 3-4 days before only they will be giving some messages saying that on particular day, on particular time, our application will be down. These and these services will not be available. The other services will be available, like that. And you will be wondering that some social networking websites like Facebook or Twitter, whatever it is, they are also coming up with everyday new features. But have you ever seen that a message is saying like this in a social networking websites? Definitely no. How it is happening again? I said that we'll be keeping a web application in a web server. A web server is there, and for a time being, our to have a backup to make application as a robustness, what they will do is, instead of depending on a one server, they buy that another web server. So in these two places your applications will be there. What will happen is, users can be accessed the first from the web server 1, and they will be making changes in a web server 2. So as long as you are changing or you are adding some enhancements to the web application, the current web application, that will be taking part in a web server 2. So users will be connecting to the web server 1, they will be accessing that application without any interruption. Once they feel that all the applications enhancements is done, they'll be testing that. After they feel that everything is working fine, then they'll connect you to the web server 2. That time immediately they can see that new features. Once they log off and log in, they can see that new features. So that way the maintenance is very, very comfort and user friendly for customers with this web application. So only nowadays, whoever develop an application, they want it to be on the go. Nowadays it is like not only web application, they wanted a mobile application, they wanted to hold in a hand and they wanted to take it wherever they want to go. So standalone application means you'll be installing it on a computer and you cannot get this online updates because it doesn't require to connect to the internet. But with web application, it will be connecting with the online updates. So there are more advantages with web application projects compared to the Windows applications. Still there are requirements are there with Windows applications as well, but comparatively very low with this web application. So people will be preferring to learn, and organizations also preferring to recruit the persons who is having web application experience. So that's why we'll be covering most of the times with web application and console application. And let me take one a practical example instead of telling this everything theoretical. I'm having Visual Studio 2012, that's ultimate version. Let me open a project. How to open it? After clicking on it, you can just click here and choose a new, click on project. Let it load. It'll take a few seconds. Let it load. Yes, see here, a console application is there. Now let me take this sample program. So this is our project name. Click on OK. It will be creating. Let it create. See this. Once you have created your application, the 15 lines of code has come automatically. You have not yet written anything. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to write a program. The program is, we are going to check that dividing a number. So we require a numerator and denominator. The conditions are like, if you ask a user to enter a number, suppose please enter a number, if I ask, he may press 5 or 10, or there are chances that somebody ping me, we need to familiarize with Java. Is this a question or a statement, Sarita? No, it doesn't require to have any knowledge before joining this .NET. I'll make you people that in a suppose a non-IT background guy also can prepare or can create an application or a project on his own at the end of the course. Today, if you don't know anything, what I need from you is you should understand English language and you should follow my instructions and you should do the assignments what I'm giving, and I'm there always to help you if you are getting anything trouble from the technical thing. I'm always there to help you via technical things. So if you attend my all sessions without fail, and if you follow that sessions, and if you do the assignments, simple assignments that I'm going to give, definitely you'll be in a position at the end of the course, you can create your own project. That's my promise from my end. Okay. And suppose if you enter a number by mistake like this, and this is not a number. So the first condition is, if he type anything other than number, we need to tell him that the program should let the user know only numbers can be added. And one more thing is, if user enters a very large number, at that time also we'll be telling that large numbers are not allowed. Then we'll be giving some range. So first condition is, if the user enters some alphabetic number, suppose if I ask you to enter a number, you may press 10, like 10. So that time the program should let the user only numbers are allowed. So if the user enters 10, instead of 10, actually the number I'm telling, instead of number 10, if you type like this 10, then the program should let the user know, the program should let the user know only numbers are allowed. This is the first condition. And then one more condition, if the user enters very large number, if the user enters very large number, that time also the program should let the user know about the range allowed. The program should let the user know only the range is allowed. And when you are doing that division, the denominator should not be zero. Should not be zero. That is this one. You know, I guess if you have a denominator is a zero, what will happen? Suppose let me show you 10 divided by zero. See, cannot divide it by zero. So if any of these things happen, we wanted to show this kind of messages. If user enters 10 digits like this, alpha characters, we need to show these are not allowed. If he enters a very large number, again we need to show this large numbers are not allowed, and we'll be giving some range. Within that range only you need to enter, and denominator should not be zero. Like that also we can take this. So let me take this an example with this Visual Studio. So this is of a console application. With this we can how this program by using C#.NET. See, you can see .cs. This stands for C#. If you have selected Visual Basic, here you can see .vb. At the time of installation only, it will be asking you whether you need C# or VB.NET. There will be a checkboxes. If you choose C#, then your program or projects will be under C#. If you choose VB at the time of installation, you can be seeing the programs in a VB only. Now In a console application, hi, you're told that we'll be asking please enter a number. So how to write to a console something? Here we have seen already the command prompt, normal command prompt, how it look like. So as similar to this, Visual Studio also will be looking the same way. How to write to console? A console class is there and we'll be using a method called WriteLine method. Do not worry about this class, what is that I'm talking. A console is a class, a program is a class, it's a namespace. In a regular class, we'll be discussing each and everything in a simple terms. What under this main method is came, and what is this void means, what is this args means, what is this method write line is, what are this, why is these lines are required. We'll be covering all the things in our regular classes. As of now, just concentrate on that, how we are achieving these things. Okay, just follow me and just see that how the Visual Studio is and how the C# is and how the console application is. Okay, now we have a class called console and a write line is a method. C# beautiness is if you just mouse over on it, it will be giving the information. See, I told that console is a class, you can verify it by mouse overing on it. It will be there, the first word itself, a class system.console. What is that system again? System is a this one, namespace. If you remove this, suppose how to remove this, let me delete it. See, immediately we are getting an error message. So this is the beauty of this Visual Studio. It will be teaching you more. See what it's telling. The name console does not exist in the current context. So to avoid that, we can give here only the system. A fully qualified name we can call it as. See, now it is not throwing error. And not only in one place we'll be using this console class. In our program, we'll be using most of the places console class. So instead of typing every time system.console, we can type only at one place, then onwards we can use it wherever we want that console class. So that is the reason we'll be keeping in this place system. So we have given on top of this application, you no need to give every time. You can directly use a console class wherever you want. So how to write to console is by using console class write line method. Please enter a number for numerator. Okay, he will be typing. Then how to read it? How to read from the console? Then again we have read line. So by this we can read the number. Okay, we can read it, but we wanted to store in some other place for our calculations. How to do that? As the person will be entering a number, right? So we have data types in our Visual Studio. Again, do not worry about the data types word. Data type means it will be holding the data accordingly. Accordingly in the sense, numbers will be stored somewhere else, names will be storing in somewhere else. So as it is a number, I'll be taking integer. Integer numerator, that is equals to this one. Again, here it is throwing error. Why is this error is coming? You just mouse over it and you can read that error message at the end. Cannot implicitly convert type string to integer. So this is of type integer and this is of type string. You just mouse over on it and read the first line. It is showing string console.readline. What we are trying to do is, we are trying to convert one type of data to other type of data. That's why it is throwing error. So we need to tell that please convert into some data type called integer 32. Before assigning, the value will be converting into the integer, then we can assign it to the another integer. In the same way, we need for other number also, right? Denominator also we required. Please enter number for denominator. Then again, here it is numerator, here it is denominator. So we have two numbers, one is numerator, another one is denominator. Here it is there. Now what we can do, we wanted to store or we wanted to calculate that numerator by denominator, and again that will be a integer. Integer result is equals to numerator divided by denominator. Okay, now here we wanted to display this to the user. Whatever user is entering, we wanted to display to the user about the result. Now to write something on a console, again we will be using console.writeLine. Here result is like this, console.readKey. See, I'll tell that why I wrote this console.readKey. Till now I told only two methods under console. WriteLine is to use for to display something on a console. So I wrote here how to write to a console and how to read from the console. Your user has given one number, then how to read it by using console.readLine. How to write it is console.writeLine method. Then this is our logic we have created. Integer result is equal to number divided by, numerator divided by denominator. And then how to display the result to the end user, whatever he has asked. He asked the division of this number by this number. Now, how to run this program? There are two things for all the programs in Visual Studio. One is compilation, other one is this one, execution. So compilation will be doing like this, build solution. This is called compilation. Then execution is, you can click on this start button, or else go to debug and you can click this one. This can be done from your keyboard also. Please press function F5 keyboard. If I use keyboard, you cannot see it. So most of the times I'll be utilizing the options which are there on the screen. So I'm clicking on start. Let me increase the font size. So it is asking, please enter a number for numerator. Suppose I pressed 10. Please enter a number for denominator. Sorry, I'm spelling. It's 2. Now result is 5. Fine, right? Application is working fine. Now, what's our concept? We need to have these conditions to verify it. If user enters 10, what will happen? For that, let me check it. That also. Suppose by mistake, instead of 10 like this, I pressed. This is the one it is showing. See, this kind of error messages will be irritated to the normal customers. They do not understand what is this error about. By mistake, they would have pressed like this. And if you are showing like this message, users will get frustrated and they cannot understand the error message. So unhandled exception. First of all, this is technical term. What is the exception? You don't understand it. Here it is showing input string was not in a correct format. How to handle these kind of exceptions? Let me show you that how to handle. Instead of showing this big error messages, we'll be showing some user friendly error messages. To do that, we always need try catch block helps. All the thing we have kept in a try catch. We have format exception. console.writeLine. What my intention is, instead of showing this technical errors to the end users, we require to give user friendly error messages so that users can understand what happened, went or what went wrong, so that you can rectify that error message when next time execution. Please enter numbers only. Now let me execute it. What will happen? See, compared to that earlier message and this error message, which one is good? Definitely, this kind of error message showing to end users is always preferable. Instead of showing technical error messages, it was showing unhandled exceptions that time. So this is how a good way of showing error messages to the end users. Now next thing is, if user enters very large number, the program should let the user know only the range is allowed. How to do that? First, let me type very large number. Suppose the numbers only I'm pressing, sorry, only numbers. If I press by mistake like this, see again what we are getting: unhandled exception, system.overflow exception, value was either too large or too small for integer 32. How to make it understand that? Users should understand what has went wrong. Sorry, again we'll close this. Now we'll have something called overflow exception. So that number should be not less than or not greater than that number whatever user is entering. Let me take this help catch, then here it is, overflow exception. Please enter numbers in this range, otherwise we'll give some other meaningful error messages like only numbers between this and that are allowed. Only numbers within some range we can mention. Only numbers between are allowed, and then which numbers those are. Here let me mention that int dot min value is there, comma int dot max value is there. So what will happen is, if you enter big number, it won't allow you, or if you enter less than this number, it won't allow you. What are these numbers? First let me show you that. Sorry, so before printing this, I'll be taking this, and then minimum value is 1. So your value should be within this range, either minimum value and maximum value. Okay, now let us see that whether how it is allowing. The minimum value should be this one and maximum value is this one, not less than this number and not greater than this number. Suppose if I enter, let me enter the big number now. See, only numbers between this it is showing. So I cannot enter a very large number, either it is smaller than this number or greater than this number. Now let me show that whether it is really working or not. This is minimum value, right? Suppose if I go with -214 748 36, instead of 48 I'm giving a less number, 49. So in minus it is there, right? 49. So 48 is a bigger value, 49 is a smaller value. If I press enter, it will be showing error message. Only numbers between this, the one is allowed. So our program is logically following the conditions what our client had put. User enters a very large number, the program should let the user no, only the range is allowed. And suppose if I enter a maximum value more than that specified, what will happen? This is the one, 214-748-3648. Again, it is throwing message. So this will be allowing only the numbers between this range. Now, another condition, e-output denominator should not be a zero. How to achieve that? Let us take another catch. Let me take help from this. Divided by zero exception. Here we can. So if I don't have this, first of all, what will happen? Let us see that. So before putting this catch, I'm trying to do something called 50. Then second number is zero. See what's happened? Unhandled exception. So instead of showing this kind of error message to the user, we'll be catching that exceptions and then we'll be showing that user friendly error messages instead of showing this kind of error messages. Close it. Then let me do this. Denominator cannot be zero. So what my intention is, user should enter only the numbers. Here it is. If he enters something else than numbers, we'll be throwing this error message. And users are entering numbers only, but if they are entering very huge numbers, then only I'm showing this error messages. And he is entered number only and he entered within a range only, but that was zero. Again, that is also not allowed because we cannot do division by zero, whatever the number it is. Suppose 8 is there, if I divide by zero, it cannot be divided by zero. So that exception also we are following. Now let us see that number is there, and if I press zero, it is showing that denominator cannot be zero. Understand? We are following all the conditions that the client had put for us. And sometimes you cannot expect that maybe you can get other exception also. Apart from these exceptions, console.writeLine. Something else we can put at other message, like let me take here ES.message. So this error message we cannot predict. So whatever the error message come at the time of execution, it will show that particular message. Example, like when you are dealing with a database and when you are connecting to the database and you are getting the data, that time the database server also may be down. We cannot predict it. So that type of error messages will be covered here. And remember that this exception is the final exception that can cover all the exceptions. And the remaining exceptions should be there before this exception. Suppose if you have this exception, after this exception, it will throw error message immediately. See, a previous catch clause already catches all exceptions of this or of super type. Means that this exception will be there under this format exception. So let me comment this. Commented, then let me comment this thing also. Now still this program will work. Let us see this. Suppose if I press like this, input string was not the correct format. Still this is not in a user friendly error message. What user can understand? Input string. So always think from user perspective. He don't aware of this, what is this string called? Is he don't know what is the string. So we need to give user friendly error messages. So only we have given, please enter, not here, in catch only, please enter numbers only. So this is also a good error message, but compared to this error message, like this kind of error message will be always giving some more information to the client to enter his valid input. Understand? Like in the same way, if I give this one, input was either too large or too small for into 32. Still, you cannot understand it. We are giving a clarity of this information. So only we'll be using this kind of error messages will be showing to the end users. Hope you understand this. It's not required. Okay. Hope you understand how to catch exceptions and how to deal those exceptions. Instead of showing this technical error message to the end users, please follow that showing a meaningful error messages to the end users. Please let me know if you have any question here with this program. And to conclude, there are many opportunities for this .NET resources, whoever having .NET resource, the skill set like C#, ASP.NET and this SQL Server. There are plenty of job opportunities you will be getting, and for that H2K Infos will be always helping you to get jobs as well, and they will be providing some mock interviews also. Please contact them for this more details, and from my end I will be helping you for all the technical related questions whatever you have for the subject. And my promise is that when you join today or when you join any day, you no need to have any knowledge in any of the course. If you have some interest, then that will make you to understand .NET. We should have something like you need to attend classes regularly, and you should follow the instructions what I'm telling, and you should do the assignments what I'm going to give, simple assignments. Definitely it is not a school or a college. It will be following you every day, like have you done or not. It is like, if you have problems, you should approach me, then I will be helping you. It's like not a micromanagement you will be doing, whether I have done it or not. It is depends on your interest. So you will be reaching me if you have any questions via email, call this one, reddyhu@gmail.com. Not only in the class, if you feel any hesitation to ask a question in a class, you can always reach me via this email. And sometimes you may not get a question in the class. After having the class, you may be getting the question. Anything which is related to the technical things, you can please approach me via this email ID. I'll be there always to help you guys. If anybody have any questions, please let me know. So with this, a demo class is done. If anybody have any questions, please stay back. Otherwise, you can log off for the day. Yeah, one question from the other student. It may be helpful for the other students also. The question was, how easy is .NET compared to Java? The thing is, learning perspective, it is very easy compared to the Java. Java, you need to write all the things. In .NET, you don't need to write so many things. All the things are already there. You just need to use the things. You'll be having toolbox. You need to use the things what are there. Suppose if you wanted to write or if you wanted to display a text box, you no need to type anything, a small line of code also. You need to take that just from a toolbox. There are many applications are available. I mean, many controls are available. You just drag and drop. That is the biggest advantage with any of the other technologies compared to .NET. Yes, the other question is, what are all the .NET topics are covered if you take this course? That's a good question. I'll show you that the syllabus that is there in a HTK website only. Here you can go to the courses. Here you can see Microsoft.net. Come down. Then you can see these course highlights and deep syllabus is written here. Topic wise Microsoft.net course details. This is the syllabus we'll be covering. Not more than this and not less than this till final project work. I guess nobody is there in this class. The students, you don't need to submit a project in your colleges, I guess. And then what is the difference between console application and a web application? A console application will be looking like this. We have seen here. Okay. And web application is like we have this one. This is a web application. One kind of web application example. And Facebook is a web application. Yeah. And another question is duration of the class and how long? That's correct question. Let me tell you that. Every day, Monday to Friday, I'll be taking the same time, I think 8 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. That is 90 minutes of the class every day. And duration is 9 weeks to 10 weeks. It's like 2.5 months. Monday to Friday I'll be taking 8 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. It's a 90 minutes class. 9 weeks to 10 weeks we'll be taking the class. It's like 2.5 months. Any other questions? Yeah, Chiki, that's another question from other student. Could you explain if .NET is server or client-side programming? These are server-side programming only. A client-side is JavaScript or HTML thing, whatever it is. It is a pure server-side programming. C#.NET, ASP.NET, we are going to discuss. That is a server-side programming, Chiki. Still, we'll be taking help from the JavaScript. It is a client-side programming. It is required as well for our anything we are doing validations. Still, that and also will be discussed as part of this syllabus that you can see here in syllabus. We mentioned that also. Introduction to Web Technologies, JavaScript is there. Here we'll be discussing about JavaScript as well as part of the course. Any other questions? The entire class or entire course will be discussed in a C# programming and ASP.NET. When is this course going to start? Other question. It's already started. Only one or two classes done. If you can join, then it will be easy for you to pick up the classes. So that one or two classes I'll be taking you guys separately. Then we'll club into the regular class. Please ask me if you have any other questions. Other question is, do you teach basic programming? Definitely, from basic to advanced, this course will be covering. these are all basic things we'll be covering. See here, when you look at the syllabus, these two chapters will be discussing about theoretical part, and from here only we'll be starting a programming things. From why Windows Forms, Hello World, compiling an exam, why do we need a SQL Studio? All the things are very, very basic things. I'll be giving examples for each topics. Then I'll be making you to understand. Then only I'll be moving to that next topic. Everybody in the class should understand. Then only we'll be moving to the next topic. Thank you, Sarita. Any other questions? Please let me know. So that the question which you are asking, it will be helpful to other students also. Yeah, you are welcome, Paulina. Yes, the next question is, how is the .NET market? I know Java is open source, but .NET is not. Exactly, the one is correct. But these two are very much competitive in the market, Java and .NET. Definitely, you will be getting jobs in the market of .NET more, because there are many options are available. If you learn Java, only Java will be there. In .NET, you can learn C#, ASP.NET, VB.NET, any other like languages also you can learn. So there is more chances for you to get jobs under .NET. Again, still there is a big debate will be there, Java and .NET. In a internet, if you verify that, some guys will say Java is good, some guys will say .NET is good. Forget about that. It's up to us that which one to select, and it is depend on our interest as well, which one we wanted to learn. There are more jobs available for .NET. Thank you. Yes, the other question is, does .NET need to be upgraded periodically in terms of knowledge skills? Yes, I should agree for this. Correct. Not only .NET, whatever the technology you are taking, whatever the language you are learning, every day or every time you need to upgrade yourself. Being it is a software industry, you should be in a position that you should catch the new things which are getting every day. Otherwise, you will be not treated as quick learner, or the things which are getting, you are not taking into the resumes. Any other question? Yes, that is the first level is junior developer. That's correct. And again, in organizations, in different organizations, different positions will be there. That name will be different. Sometimes some organization will call junior developer, sometimes will call assistant engineer, like that. So it is like a fresher kind of jobs you'll be finding. Forget about the name they had given. It is like entry engineer. How do you get experienced as a senior? I didn't get your question. How do you get experienced? So as, yes, see, if you want to get experience, you should work in something else. So only you can get it. And again, it is depending on the performance you are providing in your company, and you'll be there reviews of your performance. Depending on that performance reviews, you'll be promoted to senior developer. It is not like a fixed number of years to get senior developer. It depends on, again, it, in your organization. Sometimes some guys wanted to make you to put in a senior developer position. They can make it you after 2 years or 3 years. What is the toughest part where you see students struggle a bit? The toughest part is logical thinking. Say some students will be lacking logical thinking. Those who do not have logical thinking, it's the toughest part. The only thing in this IT industry for a developer is to have logical thinking. Okay, if you have any more questions, please drop an email to here for technical things. It'll always be helpful to you. Okay, welcome Chiki. Thank you for attending. We'll meet again if you are going to join the class. Thank you, bye.